There are fresh health alerts across Victoria and New South Wales this morning after both states recorded new COVID cases. But despite these concerns, Australian Open organisers are confident the tournament can go ahead as planned. We have reporters covering every angle for you at home this morning. First to today, Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn at Melbourne Park. Chris, the virus has once again escaped hotel quarantine.
Carl, that's right. This alert came out just before midnight that a female worker at the Holiday Inn at the Melbourne airport tested positive just after she turned up for her morning shift yesterday and began to feel unwell. Three potential exposure sites have been identified. They are Marciano's Cakes in Maidstone, Dan Murphy's in Sunshine and Off Your Tree Store in Water Gardens. Full details on the department website. Now, the Holiday Inn was not a tennis hotel. However, there is, of course, concerns about community transmission. The Australian Open boss confident that the tournament will go ahead unscathed.
The way the site is set up, everyone's going to be safe, protected, and on top of that, get back to seeing some great tennis and being part of what is so special to us Melburnians.
200 extra ADF troops are on their way to help out with our embattled hotel quarantine program. There was meant to be a plane load of troops arriving last night, but the plane broke down in Townsville. But the Defence Minister revealed on our program this morning that 50 troops did in fact make their way to Melbourne overnight.
Carl. Christina Hearn, thank you.
Let's go now to today. Sydney reporter Gabrielle Boyle in Wollongong, south of Sydney. And Gabby, contact traces are scrambling after a return traveller tested positive there 2 days after leaving quarantine.
They certainly are scrambling, Layla. This individual has returned from living overseas and done the mandatory 14 days in hotel quarantine. He or she has tested negative repeatedly and been let out into the community, but it was 2 days after being released into the public that this person has returned a positive result. And that has meant contact tracers have had to scramble, listing a number of locations as key points where they want people to be warned. Those include the Headlands Hotel at Austin Mirror. I'm joining you from this morning, Bulleye Beach Cafe and the Mooch and Me Cafe at Brighton Le Sands. It's worth noting that people that were living with this individual have been tested and they have returned a negative result. Layla?
Thank you very much, Gabby.
The South Australian government is also considering bringing in the day 16 test for those who leave hotel quarantine. It comes as the state bolsters its hotel quarantine system today, with health workers moving into a dedicated facility which will house infected arrivals to separate them from those who don't have the virus. West Australian students will return to school and workers will go back to the office today after Perth emerged from its 5-day lockdown. It's believed the snap shutdown is expected to cost the local economy $500 million. West Australia hasn't recorded any additional cases since the hotel worker triggered the lockdown. The death of a 22-year-old woman in Townsville has fuelled growing calls for tougher youth justice laws in Queensland. Today, reporter Rhys Alessandro joins us now. Rhys, good morning to you. A 17-year-old girl will face court today.
Yeah, that's right, Alex. 17-year-old charged in relation to that crash in Townsville, which claimed the life of 22-year-old Jennifer Board. She was on a motorcycle and it collided with a Holden sedan, which was allegedly chasing a stolen car in Townsville on Friday night. Her family has not only had to deal with the grief, but also a fake fundraising page being set up in her name and their daughter's home being ransacked as well, as if this couldn't get any worse. This is an issue which has gained more and more traction over the past fortnight. We know Premier Anastasia Palaszczuk will hold crisis talks with senior cabinet ministers today in a cabinet meeting, and we are expecting an announcement from the government on youth crime before the end of the week. All of these calls, of course, sparked by the Alexandra Hills crash on Australia Day 2 weeks ago. Tomorrow, we lost Kate Ledbetter, Maddie Field and their unborn baby in that crash. Today, Alex, they'll be laid to rest in a private funeral service east of Brisbane.
Thank you, Rhys. South Africa has halted the rollout of the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine following a study revealing the jab doesn't protect against minor to moderate cases of the country's mutant strain. But the Australian government says we shouldn't be worried about the jab's effectiveness overall. Here's the Federal Health Minister on 2GB a little earlier.
What we've seen is additional data coming out of the UK recently. I spoke with the UK Health Secretary in recent days. That's their Health Minister equivalent. They're having very strong results.
Work is already underway on a modified vaccine due later this year. One of sport's biggest showdowns is about to kick off, with the Kansas City Chiefs set to battle the Tampa Bay Buccaneers in this year's Super Bowl. Let's head to Florida, where we find our US correspondent, Michael Genovese. Jenna, g'day. What's happening there?
Alex, good morning to you again. Well, things have certainly changed since we spoke last. We were at a Super Bowl viewing party, and as we get closer to kickoff, everyone's been kicked out. They're shutting it down, but this gives you an idea of just how many people were here. They're on the other side of the fence now. A lot of social and not much distance, I guess you could say, and very few masks. It flies in the face of the official advice from the CDC, which is to stay at home and watch the Super Bowl by yourself. They're a little bit concerned that the Super Bowl could become a super spreader event. They're trying to avoid that. But ironically, it's the fact that the stadium has now been reduced from 66,000 down to 25,000 people. It's left a lot of these Tampa Bay residents with nowhere else to go and watch the game. They were told to stay home, many of them out and about today, as they get a little bit closer to kickoff. It is a city that's absolutely buzzing right now, and a lot of that buzz is around Tom Brady and how he's going to go after kickoff.
43 years old. Amazing stuff, Jenna. Thank you for that.